Well, based on the auditions, because I didn't go to the cattle call because I had an agent, I'd already had a series, so I had my own private audition. The first audition was just reading from a script. It was all about acting and comedy. And I think the second audition was all about reading and acting and doing scene work. And then there was a number of auditions, more than usual. One of the auditions I recall was playing. And everybody got to sing a song, and they set up a little kind of band area. And they, it was on the I Dream of Jeannie set, as a matter of fact.
In the driver, let me ask you something now. What are you doing with one sneaker on?
I can't make decisions, that's the truth. No, see, these guys have boots on, you know, and like, I didn't know, I was told to dress casual, so I came in a plaid shirt and my surfer tennies, you know, and my blue Levi's, and then these guys have Beatles stuff on, you know, with a Levi jacket.
His personality.
So I...
Elephant boy!
It's funny, he's been asking about you, too.
Hey, Mick, how long has it been, fella?
How long has it been?
Since what?
About an hour and a half ago, I got it.
I don't recall there being an enormous emphasis on the musical abilities. So maybe they didn't know or care. Maybe they thought, maybe they figured we'll get lucky. But having said that, everybody that they did hire could certainly sing and or play. Peter was by far the most accomplished musician. He plays five instruments, you know, quite well. Mike only plays guitar, but plays it very well, a very distinctive kind of country, electric country sound. I played a little guitar, a little piano, never played the drums before. Davey played a little guitar and, you know, became quite good at percussion. Davey was probably the one that had the least experience on an instrument. So I've never actually considered myself a musician, but they obviously, I probably got by on my singing. I think that was, looking back, I think that was probably my strong suit, was my rock and roll singing, even in the early days. But there was a lot of scene work, a lot of improvisation, and but then again, you know, I'm speaking from my point of view as an actor, because at the time, you know, I was an actor, and I always approached the Monkees as an actor playing the part of a drummer in this imaginary group that lived in this imaginary beach house and had these imaginary adventures. To me, that's always been what it's about. When I was cast as the drummer, I mean, I remember them saying, you're going to be the drummer. And I said, I don't play drums. I said, it's okay. I said, I play guitar. I said, well, we have three guitar players, so you're going to be the drummer. And I think that they configured it, again, I'm only second guessing. I think they configured it as much visually and also given our personalities. Because remember, this was a television show about a group. It wasn't a group. When she told me to forget it, and I bet you will forget it when they find me in the morning, wet and drowned, and the wood gets round. Going down, I'm going down. I'm coming up for air, it's pretty stuff under there. I'd like to say I didn't care, but I forgot to leave a note, and it's so hard to stay afloat. I'm soaking wet without a boat, and I knew I should have taken off my shoes. It's front page news.